Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to create your first C++ application using NetBeans. So the first step will be how to download and install MinGW, then how to install the C++ plugin, then how to create a C++ project, and finally how to run a C++ application. So first of all, let's download and install MinGW. So we have to click on this first link. And here, as you can see, this is the number of times this installer has been downloaded during this week. So let's click on this download button. Now let's save this installer. So I will save it on the desktop. Now let's run it. In this window, I have just to click on install. Then here I will accept this default path where MinGW will be installed. Now let's click on continue. Now let's click on continue. And in this window we have to select basic setup. Also we need to select the first package which allows us to install MSys, and MSys includes the make tool. So let's select it and let's click on mark for installation. Now let's select the second package which allows us to build C files. And let's select this package which allows us to build C++ files. Now let's click on installation, then apply changes. And here let's click on apply. And now we have to wait a few minutes depending on the internet connection speed. Now the installation finished successfully, so let's close this window and this window. Now we need to add MinGW and MSys to the system environment variables. So let's go to the folder where they are installed. So they are installed in this folder, MinGW. Now let's open this binary folder and let's copy this path. And let's add it to the system environment variables. So we have to click on Advanced System Settings, then Environment Variables, then we have to find the path variable which is this one, so let's edit it, and at the beginning of this field I will paste the path. I will add a semicolon as a separator. Also I have to add MSys to the System Environment Variables, so let's go back to MinGW, then MSys, then this folder, then the binary folder, and let's copy this path. Now we can close this folder and we have to add the path to this field. So let's add a semicolon and now we can click on OK. Then OK, OK again, and let's close this window. Now let's open NetBeans. So let's go to Tools, then Plugins, and here I want to install a new plugin for C++. So I should find it here, but here I cannot find it. So let's go to Settings, let's select this first option, then here we can find it. So if you don't find it, you have just to click on Check for newest. Also before clicking on Check for newest, you have to go to Installed and to deactivate this package. So you have just to make a right click, then deactivate. In my case it is already deactivated. So here let's go to available plugins and let's select this plugin for C and C++ applications. Now let's click on install, then next, then we have to accept the license, then install. So after about 2 minutes, we obtain this error which says that this tool called NPack200 does not exist. And this tool does not exist in new Java versions. This is why you need to install an old Java version, like for example Java 11. So here we have just to close NetBeans. And we need to download and install an old GDK, for example GDK 11. So here let's type Java GDK. Now let's go to this first link. And here let's scroll down. So here we can find that we can download GDK 11. So let's click on this. Now if we scroll down, we can click on Windows and we can download the installer for GDK 11 and Windows. So let's click on this link. Of course, we have to accept the license. Now let's click on download. And in this page, you need to log in using an account. So if you don't have an account, you can create a new one for free. In my case, I have an account, so I will select it. Then let's log in. Now I can download the installer of GDK 11. But in my case, I have already downloaded it, so I will cancel this download. And also, I have already installed it. So for this reason, I will just go to the location where NetBeans is installed to configure it to use GDK 11. So NetBeans is installed on the C drive in program files into a folder called NetBeans12.4. So I have to open this folder, then etc. Then I have to open this configuration file. So here, if I scroll down, I can see that actually NetBeans is using this GDK, which is GDK 16. So I have just to copy this line to paste it here. Then I will put the first line as a command. Then I will modify this value to configure NetBeans to use GDK 11. So let's go to the folder where the GDK has been installed. It is on the Java folder, into a folder called GDK 11. So I have just to copy this path and I will paste it here. Now let's save this file, but of course I need to be the administrator to be able to save this file. So let's click on yes to become administrator. And now let's save this file. Now we can close it. And let's open NetBeans again. So to check that NetBeans is actually using GDK 11, we have to go to Help, then About. And in this window, we can see that NetBeans is using GDK 11. So let's close this window and let's go to Tools, then Plugins. And let's go to Available Plugins and let's select C++. Now let's click on Install. And here let's click Next. Now let's accept the license, then let's click Install. Of course, the installation will take about 2 or 3 minutes depending on the connection speed, so we have to wait. In this window, I have just to click continue. This time the plugin has been installed correctly, so let's close this window and this. Also, we can close NetBeans to configure it again to use GDK 16. So here I will remove the command of the first line and I will put the second line as a command. Now let's save this file. Let's switch to the administrator mode. And let's save this file. Let's close it. Let's close this folder and let's open NetBeans again. Let's check the GDK used by NetBeans. So let's go to Help, then About. And here we can see that GDK 16 is used by NetBeans. So let's close this and let's create a new C++ project. So let's click on this button, New Project. Then here we have to select C++, then C++ Application. Now let's click Next. In this window, I will modify the name of the project and I will call it First CPP Application. So it will be saved at this location. And it will include a C++ file called main.cpp. So let's accept this version of MinGW, which is the version that we have installed. Now let's click on Finish. So the project has been created. Let's expand source files and you can find this CPP file. So let's open it. And it already contains this source code. So let's remove it and let's write another source code. So this is a simple source code that allows us to print this text to the user. So let's save this file and let's run it. So to run this file, we have just to click on Run, then Run Project. Or also we can click on this button. So let's click on this. And here, as you can see, this is the output. So if you have an error during the execution of the file, you have to go to Tools, then Options, then C++, and here you have to check that all of these fields are configured correctly. Also, this make tool should be configured. Now let's close this window and let's add some statements. Allows us to ask the user to provide his name, then we need to read the name of the user. So this time we will ask the user to provide his name, then we will read the name of the user, and finally we will print the name of the user as a confirmation. So let's save this file and let's run it. So here it is asked to provide the name, but I cannot type any name here. So to fix this, let's first stop this application, and now let's make a right click on this project, then Properties, then in this window we have to select Run. Then here in the console type, I have to modify the type and I will select Standard Output. Now let's click on OK. And now let's run this application again. So let's type the name. And this time, as you can see, we have the confirmation. Finally, thank you very much for watching and please subscribe to the channel.